Hello everyone. In this talk, I will discuss quadrilateral meshing of complex CAD model in GMSH. We want to build quasi-structured quad meshes, meaning they have a few regular vertices which match cross-field singularities when possible. And we want to apply this to complex CAD models. What we mean is any valid model for which we are able to build triangulations, we should be able to do quad meshes with our approach. And we want to do this while respecting all the CAD features. So all corners and curves which are in the input must be in the output. And it includes a lot of very small details, as you can see on the zoom of the zoom in the left. It's quite different from a hard edge detected by a dihedral angle. For instance, on the right, you have some cockpit of a plane, and we want to respect all these curves, because if you are doing numerical simulation, for instance, fluid flow simulations, all these small change of curvature will have an impact on the results. Quite a big impact for high Reynolds simulations. And we don't want some quads which are across curves and a bit randomly disposed. So in this context, it's not okay to cut a corner or a curve, even if there is a epsilon tolerance. We want something strict on the topology. And it's not our job to clean the CAD. What we have in input, we assume that it's what the user wants to mesh. To recap, the goal of this work is to build a good quad mesher in GMSH. We should always produce a valid quad mesh, topologically and geometrically, with strict respect of CAD features. And having a good structure with few regular vertices is more of a bonus and secondary objective. We prefer to do conservative choice to always have a valid geometry and mesh rather than the opposite. Initially, we tried to do a global parametrization attempt because we were very impressed by some results from computer graphics, for instance, the work of David Bohms and Marcel Campaign, where they are able to build very nice block structure quad meshes. And we wanted to do a similar approach in the context of CAD. But with a slight difference is that we wanted to get rid of the integer in the formulations. So our beginning is similar. We build a seamless parametrizations, which is a kind of integration of the cross field with a lot of grid preserving constraint on the cut graph and on the boundary. From this, we can extract a quad layout by taking the ISO value in the parametrization. Because our separatrice go all the way, there is no T-junctions, and we can extract the full quad mesh directly and improve it with chord collapse to have a final good quad mesh. But we had a few issues with this approach. First, it's hard to do right, because all the constraints in the linear system must be perfectly coherent. And one of the issues we had with our cross field, which are based on smoothing vector representations, is that we have no guarantees that the singularities that we will detect will respect the Poincaré of theorem. And this is because we are doing an approximated numerical approximation of a PDE, and we do not have a topological constraint or this kind of thing in this formulation. And when the singularity are wrong, or seamless parametrization is not possible. But even if this part can be fixed, maybe with another formulation, with integer for instance, as others are doing, we needed to be able to glue the phase decompositions of all the CAD faces into one final global decompositions. And to do this, we have a lot of T-junctions at the interface. At first, we thought it was okay because we would just use a global quantization of the work of Marcel Campan and others. But in practice, we encountered a lot of cases where there is no solutions. And we think this is because we have a lot of CAD curves which are complicating the problem. And when you have circular constraints, we have to collapse some of the quantizations. So some edge in the decomposition must be collapsed, but we don't know really how to do this robustly. And another difficult question is how to deal with non-manifold surface when you have multiple volume, for instance. So we took a step back, and instead of directly doing a very nice block structure quad mesh, so on the right of the scale here, we went to the easy way, which is to build an unstructured quad mesh. So for this, we can just use simple techniques, frontal point insertion. And we start here, and then we topologically and robustly improve the structure of the mesh to start to have to try to have results similar to more global parametrization approach, let's say. We will do this following the JMSH philosophy, which is bottom up. We mesh the CAD curve, then the face, constrained to curve meshes. It has a lot of advantages, and this is why we want to do this. But it has also a big issue, which is the curve quantizations, so the edge that you have on the CAD curve, they are not optimal at all by default for a surface meshing. And we fix this on rectangular CAD faces, but we do not have a generic solution for this problem. Still, we use this bottom-up approach. If we go back more to the quad meshing pipeline that we use, we build a cross-field per CAD face with its conformal scaling, and then we build also a size map which takes into account all the small features, and we blend both size map. From this, we can build an unstructured quad mesh with a frontal approach quite easily. And then we improve this unstructured mesh with a lot of cavity remeshing. So the cavity remeshing is the core of this work that I will talk more about after. First step is to remove all the highly irregular vertices that has been introduced by the frontal approach and the subdivision. So sometimes we have valence 8 vertices for vertex, for instance, and we want to remove them. On the boundary, on the curve, we can have a valence 3 or 4 instead of 2. For this, we use the best local re-quadrangulations. And for this, we have a tabulated list of all these quadrangulations, and we just take the best one in terms of final regularity. But each time we do this, we have to verify the geometry is okay. So we untangle the mesh, compute the quality, and take it off only if it's okay. Second part, and more important in this work, is pattern-based quad meshing. In the quad mesh, you have a lot of pattern if you look from far away. So you have a polygon with some sides and a fixed number of edges on the sides. And you want to find a quad mesh which match this given boundary. And we can do this by solving linear integer problems, where the unknown are the number of subdivisions on the topological chords, which are the dashed lines here. So by applying this cavity remeshing, first we can build a very big quad mesh of whole CAD faces. Because even if the CAD model is complicated, Lot of faces are very simple, like they have triangular, rectangular, or pentagonal topologies. And then we can try this pattern matching method, map the mesh, smooth it, and if it's okay, we keep it. Second step is to apply massively this cavity remeshing inside the quad mesh. So for this, we will grow cavities in the unstructured mesh and replace a patch of quad by a more regular pattern. Here we go from 11 irregular vertices on the left to just one on the right. Of course, we always have to verify the geometry. It's not a new idea, it has been done in the past, but the thing which was missing in our opinion is there was not really control. It was in engineering, it was applied in a greedy way, and when you do this, you have progressively you will move the irregular vertices, even if you reduce the number, and you will kind of destroy the global structure. And in the end, the mesh has few irregular vertices, but they are not well placed, and you have a lot of distortion. So the thing that we did differently is that we preserve cross-field singularities. On this example, we build triangular and pentagonal cavities around the cross-field singularities, and iteratively, we remesh all these cavities and reduce the number of irregular vertices. In the end, we have a quite nice quad mesh matching all the cross-field singularities. So it's the same result as with the global parametrization on this example. But it's not so easy when you have a complex CAD model, because there are a lot of small CAD features, and there we need to have a size map adapted to the CAD. It's because of the curve sampling. As the curves are mesh first, the surface meshing problem is too constrained if you have a sparse point on the curves and small features. So to have kind of dense sampling at small features, we use this size map. And then it's possible to have a nice local quad mesh. So here is the size map, for instance, on the big models. You can see on the right there is quite a big range, like three order of magnitudes in the edge sizes. Here is the final result on the same model, where so the mesh, we are quite happy with it because all the elements have good qualities locally. Statistically, it's a very good quad mesh, but we have a lot of irregular vertices. To do the transition from the small feature parts to the coarse regions. But still, we are quite happy with this kind of result because all the CAD features are perfectly respected, and we have a good quality. Here are some examples on many models. So this approach is quite generic, and so for each mesh, if you look very well, it's not the best mesh. There are too many irregular vertices, but it's a very generic approach which have some kind of good results in terms of quality. And so the key lessons of this work to conclude that we had to find a very robust approach without failure cases. So it's why we always check the geometric quality after each operation, etc. Because when you have a big model, even if your method works most of the time, on a big model you have dozens of tricky cases where it can fail. And if the whole thing falls apart when it fails, then you are never able to mesh them. That's it. For future work, we want to finish the GMesh integration, so soon it will be in the standard distributed GMesh, and to finish the paper. There are also a lot of long-term improvements, new features that we would like to add, but it's for later. Thank you for your attention, and please don't hesitate if you have questions.